we want to simplify the given trig expressions, which normally means we want to write them in terms of a single trig function if possible. Looking at these two expressions, notice how we have trig functions squared, which means we should be looking at the Pythagorean identities to perform substitutions as a first step. So looking at this first expression, we have cosecant squared theta divided by the quantity cosecant squared theta minus 1. So we should be looking at this identity here. Notice the numerator is cosecant squared theta, which means we could substitute 1 plus cotangent squared theta for this cosecant squared theta. But that would give us a sum in the numerator and a difference in the denominator, which should be even more involved to simplify. So let's take a look at our denominator. We have cosecant squared theta minus 1. Looking at this identity here, notice if we subtracted 1 on both sides, we would have cotangent squared theta equals cosecant squared theta minus 1. So we can substitute cotangent squared theta for our denominator. And notice how that would eliminate the difference in the denominator. So let's go ahead and do that. We'll have cosecant squared theta divided by cotangent squared theta. And from here, we'll convert the sines and cosines. Since cosecant is equal to 1 divided by sine theta, cosecant squared theta would be 1 over sine squared theta. And since cotangent theta is equal to cosine theta over sine theta, cotangent squared theta will be cosine squared theta divided by sine squared theta. Now this fraction bar here represents division, so we can write this as a division problem. So we'd have 1 over sine squared theta divided by cosine squared theta over sine squared theta. And now we can write this division problem as a multiplication problem if we multiply by the reciprocal of this fraction here. So let's go ahead and do that. So we have 1 over sine squared theta times the reciprocal of this fraction. So we'll have sine squared theta over cosine squared theta. And in this form, notice how sine squared theta over sine squared theta simplifies to 1. So this simplifies to 1 divided by cosine squared theta. But since 1 over cosine theta is equal to secant theta, this simplifies nicely to secant squared theta. Let's take a look at our second expression on the next slide. Because our denominator does not contain a sum or difference, we could break this up into two separate fractions and simplify this. But again, because we have trig functions that are squared, we should look at the Pythagorean identities first. Notice here we have sine squared theta plus cosine squared theta equals 1. This is a perfect match for our numerator. We can substitute 1 for sine squared theta plus cosine squared theta. So this simplifies very nicely to just 1 over sine squared theta. And since 1 over sine theta is equal to cosecant theta, this simplifies to cosecant squared theta. And that's going to do it for these two examples. I hope they were helpful.